Good morning, everyone. So far, we have completed the two units. Now it is the time to discuss the third unit, signal transmission through LTI system. And this word is important, LTI. And already in the first unit, so we have seen in brief about the system. The system means what? Did you remember the system means what? System which relates the input and output. That which operates on input signal, that means which transforms your input signal and produces the output signal. So that's why mathematically we have represented the relation between the input and output as y of t is equal to transformation of x of t, or in some textbooks it is h of x of t also there. Okay, based on that, continuous time system, that means your input signal is continuous time signal. And it also produces a continuous time signal as output. Discrete time system. Your input signal is a discrete time signal, and which transforms your input signal and produces the output signal is also discrete time signal. And single input, single output system. If only one input is given, single input. And it produces the related output, only one output, that is single output. Single input and single output, and it also will take the two or more inputs. The system may take two or more inputs also, that is multiple input and multiple output. Okay, and also we have seen the classification of the system in brief, and I explained you the classification of these seven classifications in the first unit itself, and with the relevant examples. Two or more examples we have seen, isn't it? So that classification is static and dynamic system, causal and non-causal, time variant and time invariant, linear and non-linear, invertible and non-invertible systems, stable and unstable system, and FIR and IR filter system. This FIR and IR not to the signals and systems portion, and this topic you are going to study in detail about the your third unit DSP subject. Okay. So at that time you can have a clear idea about the system, and you are going to study in detail and in depth about the system concept. Okay, then LTI system and this classification observed. So here the word LTI, linear time invariant. So in the classification, these two are more important classifications: linear and non-linear system, time variant and time invariant system. Okay, now LTI system means a system which is both linear system and also time invariant. It has to follow it has to satisfy the linearity property and time invariant property of the system. If a system is satisfying the both linear and time invariant is called LTI system, which is the most popular and important word in the throughout signals and system. And in the coming chapters also, the system must be an LTI system only. Okay, and linear system already we have discussed clearly, and just I am giving a brief idea again. Linear means it has to obey the principle of superposition. Superposition principle it has to follow, it has to satisfy. Superposition principle means what? Additivity plus homogeneity, these two laws must be satisfied. So superposition principle comprises with additivity property plus homogeneity property. So that is mathematically transformation of weighted sum of inputs. Sum means additivity, homogeneity means weighted. Addition of the two input signals along with its weights, A and B are the weights. So that is called as weighted sum of input, and the transformation will be A transformation of input, that is y1 of t is the corresponding output, transformation of x2 of t corresponding is y2 of t. So this is called weighted sum of output, the same two weights, weighted sum of outputs. So if it is like that is called linear, if not non-linear. And next, time invariant. So time invariant means if any delay in the input signal, the same delay must be reflected in the output also. That is output due to delayed input. If the input is delayed, x of t minus t delay. So the same delay must be reflect in the output. Okay. So that is representing a standard representation. Y of t comma t is the output due to delayed input, then delayed output. In the entire output, make it as a delay. Okay, if two are equal, if these two are equal, that is called a time invariant system. If not, time variant system. So that is about LTI system. Now LTV system. LTV system means either linear. It has to satisfy the linearity property, but not time invariant. Time variant. Such system is called LTV system. And next is impulse response. And the representation is h of t, which is standard representation and very important representation. In the further problem solving, we can use directly this impulse response. We can depend on that impulse response. Simple impulse response means, generally what is the representation of the input? X of t. Here the word impulse is there. So you have to give the input as the impulse signal. And what will be its transformation? Y of t is equal to transformation to the particular input impulse signal. Such response is called impulse response. Response for which? Response for whom? Response of impulse signal. Okay, that is called impulse response, and h of t is a standard representation. By seeing h of t, we must confirm that as a yes, input signal is the impulse signal. So like that. Next, response of LTI system. That means, so it will give you the relation between input signal, system, and output signal. That means, for example, if h of t is a known one, once h of t is known, then y of t for any input will be the relation between x of t and h of t in terms of y of t can be written as y of t is equal to input signal and h of t system. Its convolution. By convolving the input signal and the system, you can obtain the y of t. Once h of t is known factor, then for any input x of t, the y of t can be obtained. And apply the Fourier transform for the above. Y of t will be y of omega and x of t. And you know, you have studied the convolution property. In the time domain, if any two signals are convolved, what will be in the frequency domain? That will be multiplied, right? Okay, after applying the Fourier transform, convolution will become multiplication. Okay, x of omega, h of omega. Then the important function is transfer function. Okay, so the transfer function h of omega can be obtained. It is the ratio of Fourier transform of the output signal to the Fourier transform of the input signal is called transfer function. And next, so we'll see some properties of LTI system. Commutative properties, generally of the algebraic properties only. Like a plus b is equal to b plus c, a b is equal to b a. This is a commutative property, right? In the same way, for two signals in the convolution, x of t convolution h of t is same as h of t convolution x of t. Okay, this property is for system, LTI system. And next, the distributive property. And you know, distributive property a into bc can be written as ab into b plus a into c, right? So in that same way, distributive property, this x of t can be distributed to the two systems, h1 of t and h2 of t. And next, associative property. Associative property, what? A plus b of plus c can be written as a plus of b plus c, right? Associative property. In the same way, x of t star convolution, h1 of t convolution, h2 of t can be written as x of t convolution, h1 of t. And next, causality condition. Already you have seen the causal and non-causal systems. Then, if you know the impulse response, then you can find the causality for that. H of t is equal to 0 for t less than 0. In the discrete domain, in the discrete system DTS, h of n is equal to 0 for n less than 0. And next is stability. Stability of the system we have seen in the classification itself. And stability means for bounded input signal, it must give the bounded output signal, BIBO. The condition BIBO must be satisfied by the LTI system. Even for the LTI system also, it has to obey the BIBO principle. Okay. So then, once we know the impulse response, h of t, and this is the condition, integration minus infinity to infinity, mod h of t dt should be less than infinity. This is called absolutely integrable. In the discrete time system, summation. Discrete means that n is taking only the integers, right? That means you have to take the summation. For continuous time signals, you have to take the integration. Okay. So summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity mod h of n has to be less than infinity. This is called absolutely summable.